Hey guys, I'm back. So it's kind of been a while since I've gotten a chance to vlog. It's been a pretty busy week here in Australia. So I arrived on Wednesday. Today it's currently Sunday. So it's been pretty busy. When I first got here, I think I got a vlog in that day or the day after, I don't remember. So it's been a while, but I've really liked it so far. I am enjoying myself a little bit more each day now that I'm starting to get over my jet lag. If any of you know me, when I get really tired, I kind of get emotional. So sometimes everything could be completely fine, and nothing could be wrong. And I might just randomly start crying. It's really strange. And that's happened a couple times here. Not really that I'm homesick or anything, because I wouldn't say that I am. It's just I'm so tired and it just makes me very emotional. So that's been really fun. Not. Sorry, I'm turning my chair around. So, I have been, this is day five in Australia. So, I've done quite a bit so far. I learned how to drive on the other side of the road, which is pretty cool. In Australia, they drive on the left side of the road and on the right side of the car. So, that has been pretty difficult. But they said that I'm doing actually fairly well for an au pair. So I think that's pretty good considering I've never driven on that side of the road. So things are going pretty well in that sense. What have I done so far? Yesterday we hung out with the Marinas family. So that was cool to kind of get to meet them and see what their lifestyle is like. Very different from the States. They think my accent and the things I say are the funniest thing ever because apparently I say funny things. But I think it's hilarious because I probably would do the same to anybody that's not from the States. So I've kind of mentioned jet lag, and it's like, it's a real thing. It really is. So the strangest thing has been happening since I got here. So obviously I'm pretty tired, so falling asleep is the easiest thing I've ever done. I just close my eyes and I'm asleep, which is very, very nice. But around 3 a.m., 4 a.m. my time, I've been waking up and then it's not a panic attack, but it almost feels very similar to one where your body kind of goes numb a little bit, which is really strange. It's a weird sensation to be having in the morning. And then the rest of the morning, I can't really fall asleep and kind of toss and turn and go in and out of sleep. So today was the first time that didn't happen as much, which that was great. Probably got woken up at like 8 a.m. instead of 4 a.m. So that helps quite a bit. One of the coolest things that we did today was, and I'll include pictures, was Aiden had a singing thing at the church. So Roisin and I went into the city and explored a little bit. So we went to, it's called the Queen Victoria Building, and they have many different shops such as designers, kind of a higher end building, I would say. And so we explored that, and then we also went to Westfield, which is kind of another shopping center because they don't say mall here, it's a shopping center. And I bought Roisin a ticket and myself a ticket, and we went up into the observation tower. It's like one of their biggest buildings, here in Sydney, tallest I would say. It's not as tall as the Empire State Building or the Chicago Sears Tower. I wouldn't say it's that big. I think the sign said only 300 meters, which I don't know how many what that is in feet, so don't ask. So that was cool. Got some really cool pictures of the city. Finally got to see the Sydney Opera House from there. Haven't been close to it, but I got a sneak peek at the Opera House, which is pretty cool. One of the other coolest things that I have kind of experienced while I'm here is I've done like a lot of networking. I don't think it's really planned networking, but a lady I met today, her husband works for or Australian Opera, and that's pretty cool because he does stuff for the Sydney Opera House and things like that, which that's super, super cool because that's kind of the route I would like to go with my degree someday is working for some sort of entertainment industry, whether it's theater, movies. It was kind of cool to meet them. Another really cool thing is there's this woman. Her son sings in the choir with Aiden. I haven't met her yet, but I've heard about her. She's on CNNBC. I think I said that right. CNNBC. I probably am saying it wrong. But she's from Australia and has lived all over and works for them. And I think that's really cool because there's some really cool people. Another person is a CEO of his own like technology branch. So their branch is working on creating cars that can drive themselves without a driver, which that's amazing. Some other people that work for Amazon, some other people that work for Microsoft. A lot of really cool people out there, especially the parents of some of the students at the kids' school, seem to all be higher up there of some sort. They're not just Schmo Joe off the street wanting to send his kids here. A lot of them are really big business people, and so many people have been really kind to me so far and have made conversation with me about, oh, how are you liking it? How's the jet lag? What part of the states are you from? Which it's really nice to have that generosity and that camaraderie when you're, however far away from home, 9,000 miles or something like that. So it's really nice. And I've met a lot of people. So far, I have not met any other au pairs or people my age to kind of go out with or to hang out with yet. It's kind of been an unusual week that I haven't really had a chance to meet anyone or really had an opportunity to meet anyone. Just been busy. And I think it slows down a little bit now until Christmas. Once we get to Christmas, it's pretty busy. But I just want to check in and share some of my pictures and give an update on how things have been going here in Australia. So, see you guys probably in a couple days because, let's be real, I've been pretty busy. So, we'll catch you on the next vlog.
Hey guys, welcome back to our vlog. So right now we're walking.
I have a vlog, actually.
We're walking towards the restaurant.
No, it is
And
Bar
I'm as
Italian.
tall as Leslie, that's why I'm like above her.
No.
Yeah, and so
Cheating.
so basically we're gonna go there now, so see you there. So basically. Leslie and I are at a restaurant called Bar Italia, and we're gonna make some TikToks so we can get TikTok famous. Hey guys, it's Roisin and
Leslie.
And it's Leslie's third day in Australia.
And we're still tired.
So basically, the main thing that has happened today is that Leslie keeps calling herself Australia. Yeah, so that's pretty cool. She's already converted.
My fringe looks weird.
You said fringe! Not bangs. So, another thing that's happened. Leslie thinks my uniform looks like pajamas.
They do. For my, two subscribers. Well, ask them.
Yeah, guys, does it look like pajamas to you?
My mom will be, the only person that views this.
But you will in 10 years, remember?
Oh, yes. I'll watch this in 10 years and be like, oh, remember that girl Roisin in her pajamas that she wore to school? Roll your eyes harder. I don't think you saw your brain that time. Oh, my gosh. You are a ham.
First, I was a turkey. Now I'm a ham.
We just like calling people by meats.
Guy,
shake.
Good boy.
This Prince song inside my head. Hands up if you're down to get down tonight. 'Cause it's always a good time. Slept in all my clothes like I didn't care. Hopped into a cab, take me anywhere. I'm in if you're down to get down tonight. 'Cause it's always a good time.
Good morning.